Hey, it's Brad at Grayman Research, here to do another Glock upgrade video. Today we're going to talk about upgrading your trigger. So this is my limited gun for USPSA. Some of you guys probably do a lot of upgrades to the triggers on your own, which I've already done myself, including changing out the competition, or changing out a lot of the springs to the competition trigger springs, which you can get on various websites. Also changing the connector out to a 2.5 pound connector. And a few other things, of course, polishing up, doing like a 25 cent trigger job, which is great, and so far has done great for me, including, here, make sure it's clear, no mag in. It's great for lightening the trigger. This is a very nice light trigger pull. But the one thing this trigger does have is a very long, well, not very long, but relatively long pre-travel before you break, and then over travel as well, which isn't that much of an issue. Like in the self-defense world, you kind of want that, but when you're getting into competition and trying to maximize the efficiency and the effectiveness of your handgun in competition, you want every little upgrade you can get. Insert DK custom triggers. After doing some research online on some of the shooting forums, these came pretty highly recommended. I looked at a few other sets, and the biggest thing I wanted again was to be able to adjust the pre-travel and over-travel, not necessarily how light the trigger was, since I could already get that where I wanted it. So I'm gonna go ahead and install this and see how it works. So now that I disassembled the Glock, I've put all the new DK trigger pieces underneath the old pieces from the Glock, just to compare and contrast and see what differences there actually are. So the first thing we'll look at is the striker assemblies. So here's the old striker assembly and the new striker assembly from DK Custom Triggers. And first thing I notice is a few lightning cuts on the actual striker itself. You can see right about here, lightning cut, and you can see some lightning cuts through the spring on the body of the striker, and then a lightning cut up here towards the end. One of the things I was excited about is the enhanced tip on the striker, because any of you who have adjusted or put in lighter striker springs know that sometimes with hard primers or cheaper ammo, you can get some light primer strikes, which of course then your gun won't fire and you have a dead round in the chamber, which can get really annoying if you have reliability issues because of the upgrades you're doing. So I was hoping with a modified striker tip that it would alleviate some of that and make it more reliable with cheaper ammo, but we'll see. Maybe with a lightening of the striker, that'll increase reliability with a lightened spring. I don't know, we'll have to see. But the tips themselves don't really look that different to me. So anyways, we'll go ahead and weigh these. So we'll measure this in grams because it's such a lightweight. So the old striker assembly, 9 grams. And the new striker assembly, 7 grams. So you lose 2 grams with that new striker assembly. The next part is a safety plunger. Which right here you have the new DK Custom Trigger one and the old Glock one. The first thing that you can apparently see is, one, it's very polished, and two, it has some radiusing done around the edge here versus the old Glock right here. And also, you can kind of see in this video, the new spring looks a little bit shorter than the old spring, and actually when I'm pushing on both of them, it feels like the new spring is a little bit lighter as well. So, a few little changes, nice polishing job too. Also included is a stainless steel trigger housing pin versus the old plastic one. And then the last piece, the trigger assembly, the new one on the bottom, old one on the top. As you can see already, it's very polished compared to the old. And there's a few changes in the profile right here And also you can see the connector right here. There's a little bit of a change. Not sure what that does functionally, but a little bit of a change. And then where the money is the trigger. It's a smooth face trigger, just like this old trigger. But right up here is a set screw. See if we can zoom in on that. Okay, you can kind of see here a hole drilled and a little set screw in there, which I'm not sure if that's the pre-travel or the over-travel. And then another one right here. So that's where the money is.
So now we'll go ahead and put everything back together. So here's the end result. The new trigger installed right here, compared with an old trigger with some lightening done. So you can already see the pre-travel on the old one's going to be a lot more already. This one's already set back somewhat. So old trigger, these are already cleared. I've already cleared them, no mags in. Pre-travel, wall, break, over-travel. Where this one is pre-travel, wall, break, no over-travel. So shortened pre-travel and barely any over-travel. So then for the reset, short and very solid reset compared to the old Glock. A little bit longer, solid reset. So overall, pretty sweet for the shortening of the pre-travel and diminishing of the over-travel and a pretty short and solid reset. And now I just have to take it out to the range and try it out. So after test firing the trigger at the range, the good news is that for about 200 rounds, the trigger did very well, performed very well. Also the striker did very well. There is no light primer strikes, which I was excited about. But after about 200 rounds, a little over 200 rounds, the trigger, as you can see in this video right here, stopped activating the striker. So I don't know if the over travel set screw backed out a little bit. I'm not sure. So the Glock became inoperable at that point, which would have been catastrophic during a competition. Thankfully it didn't happen then. So I had to bring it home and adjust the over travel screw and messed with the pre-travel screw a little bit. And now it is back and functional. I'm under no illusions that when fine tuning a piece of equipment like this, that there will be no issues at all. I fully understand that there needs to be a balance between performance and reliability, but honestly, reliability should never suffer. So I'm dialing back on the performance a little bit more pre-travel, a little bit more over-travel, and hopefully we can find a setting with this trigger that will work every time, all the time. But anyway, so far I'm happy with this trigger overall, as long as we can work out a few of the bugs and find a happy medium and where this trigger would like to work with this Glock. But anyways, thanks for watching.